Hello, my name is Nancy, and in this video, I'll show you how to access the REST API of Oracle Field Service using Node.js, which I've already installed on my desktop computer and which I'll run from the console. Here's my script. I want to keep this demo simple, so I'm just going to fetch an activity and extract its city and state values. The first line loads the built-in HTTP module that provides the methods we'll need. Then I've got a variable that I'll use to hold the response to my request to get an activity. And here are the options I need to set for my request. The host is, of course, my field service site. The path points to the specific company and then to the REST interface that applies to it. Then the last two nodes of the path show that I'll be accessing the activities collection and then the specific ID number of the activity I want. I learned how to form this path by checking the field service documentation. My method, of course, is get because I'm fetching this activity. The authorization header is my username, followed by @, followed by the company name, followed by a colon, and then my password. Let me quickly remind you that I previously had to set up appropriate privileges for my role on my field service site. The only header I need to send is the content type, which is application JSON, as you see. Now in this demo app, I'm accessing a special site that doesn't have a secure certificate, so I'm going to set reject unauthorized to false, so the code will ignore that. You might not want to do this in your application, but I will in this case. Now here's the heart of my code, which is the function getInfo. First, I'll create and send my request using the options I just set up. All requests in Node.js are asynchronous, so I'll need to set up some callbacks. The first will be called when a response is received, but that response might be partial, might even be nothing but headers, at least at first. So I'll check to see that I've got actual body data here, and if so, I'll add however much data I get, which is what's in chunk, to the all data variable I set up earlier. Then here's my minimal little error handling. And here's what I'll do when the request closes because all data's been received. First, I'll print out the full body of information I received so you can see what it looks like. And then I'll use the parse method of the JSON class to get my data into a format from which I can easily extract the two fields I'm interested in, city and state. And then I'll print out a little label and then the values in those fields. And then the last line here, which is actually the first line of code that'll be executed, calls that getInfo function we just looked at. Okay, now let's run it from the console. And you can see here's my output. First, the entire activities object, JSON parsed, so you can see what fields are available to me. And then, the two fields that I was interested in, city and state, which in this case I'm only displaying here on the console, but of course I could have done whatever else I wanted with them. Thanks for watching.